In particular, is it how many different brands do you want to have in front of one brand? How many different products or services do you want to have underneath that brand? So very, very important topic, because all companies have to make these decisions. So brand architecture, a lot of this is to sort of figure out what your brand boundaries are, and then the relationships with your product. How far can your brands go? How much should I have? In what ways do they relate to other brands that you might have? In particular, we're going to talk about brand extensions, as we talked about with Nike and how they grew from the shoe company that they were into an everything athletic company. Those were a lot of extensions. Some of those were line extensions. They were within existing categories. Some of them were category extensions, like clothing and equipment, that were outside the shoe category. So we're going to talk about that some. And the thing about brand architecture is it should be a good thing. It should help you build strong brands. It should help people have the right awareness as to what you're selling, the right image of what you want your products and brands to stand for. So it should be a positive thing. Alright, so we're still talking about the very first step in architecture. Understand your brands, what could their potential be? And I gave you three examples of Crayola, Virgin, and Nivea about how you might be able to stretch, but how you have to be careful not to overstretch. All brands have boundaries. And that's why you often have multiple brands in category. Multiple brands that you offer to target different consumers. The key is to not overcome. You don't want too many brands. Fewer, stronger brands is better. The basic principle of brand portfolios: maximize coverage, minimize overlap. You want to have brands that cover the marketplace, but don't compete with each other. You want them competing with other competitors from other companies. So the most simple way is to maximize coverage, minimize overlap, and then make sure you preserve equity as you update. I'll give examples of all of this. So what I've done is I've created a little checklist, and this checklist will help you think about extensions. So first question, does the parent brand have strong equity? Two, is there a strong basis? In other words, if you don't have equity, don't try to stretch it. Two, is there a fit? Is there a nice connection there? Three, will extensions have the right points of parity, points of difference? That is crucial. That's the biggest mistake people make. Four, how can a marketing program enhance extension equity? In other words, how can we improve on that? What kind of feedback effects will you have? How much will that extension help you, help your parent brand, its equity, its profitability, and how can you improve on that? Or, if you like, you can use this scorecard I developed. I've used this with a couple different companies, a couple different brands. It just takes that checklist and creates a very, very systematic way of scoring. And you can adjust the scorecard some. The key to me is that you're being systematic and thoughtful and thorough about thinking about where you can stretch your brand and where you cannot.
And then, you do have, remember, a brand actually is
not just a name, it's a symbol, a character. Anything you can trademark is part of your brand. And you can use all those elements to help communicate how close or far an extension is. So let's talk about